In today's episode, I'm going to teach you how to get your first customer. What's up, fam? Welcome back to the show. I'm your host, CMH, founder of Startup U, an interactive learning space for online business owners. Okay, before we get started, make sure you guys like this video, hit subscribe, hit the bell for notifications, and don't forget to drop me a comment below. If you do not hit the bell for notifications, I promise I will never see you again because YouTube's algorithm has changed. And subscribing, you're probably never gonna see it again, unfortunately. So make sure you hit the bell for notifications so you know when we have new videos to help you grow your business. Okay, we are wrapping up this series. We started with this video here. Make sure you check that out, go back, because these were all done in order by design, right? So everything we did is kind of building into a cumulative effect. This is where we are, that's where we started. I'd make sure you go back and watch every video in this series so that you're able to put all the pieces together, because it's very, very important that you don't skip the steps. One of my biggest messages that I teach to my clients and to my students is you can do the steps faster, but you cannot skip the steps, right? So that's where we are, and not skipping the steps starts with you getting your first customer. So let's go ahead and jump in and talk about how you're gonna do that. Okay, so the first thing is this, right? So one of the reasons that I had you early on in the series interview at least 10 people that are potential customers for your particular product or service is because I wanted you to understand what people are looking for. Is the market viable? Test your assumptions, things of that nature. However, also something else, you now have 10 brand ambassadors, people that are out there that understand, hey, this person whom I now know or whom I know in a different capacity is offering a potential service or a potential product that maybe it could help me out, right? And so when you come back and say, hey, I'm so excited, thank you so much for your feedback and for your help. I'd love to let you know that things are now up and running and I'm excited to get started. Having that conversation, it's the natural follow-up. One of those people is likely to say, you know what? I'm gonna give you a shot. And maybe you offer a discount or, you know, for an early bird special or whatever, right? You're taking pre-order, stuff like that. Usually those people, by you just listening to them, hearing what their thoughts were on your specific market, getting their feedback about what it is that you're offering. If they truly were an ideal target or ideal customer avatar potential prospect, usually those people will give you an opportunity. And or what they'll do is say, you know, I'm not in the position that right now I'm doing something that requires or involves what you offer, but I know some people that do, or I know some people that are. So there's nothing better than having people out there providing word of mouth. Usually what I like to see from my clients is when they're early on, the best way you can, while you're building your marketing assets, while you're building your authority, while you're building your audience, the best thing you could do is start building word of mouth, particularly local word of mouth, right? So if you have those people out there that are actually ideal customer avatars that you've already built a relationship with, go back to those people, have conversations with them, tell them where you're at in the process. Say, if they indicate that they're interested, great, now you've got a potential customer. Maybe what you do is you say, hey, you know, I'd love for you to tell people about what we're doing. How can I make it worthwhile for you? Maybe you have some kind of an affiliate program or, you know, a finder's fee or a commission that you offer, something like that. I would say is a phenomenal way for you to get your first customer under your belt so you can continue to move on and go forward. Okay, next. One of the other things we talked about throughout this series is to analyze competition, right? So I look at competition a little bit different light. I think competition in a traditional capacity, although it's warranted, I typically look at competition in a sense of how can we do something that's a little bit different than what they're doing, right? Not that there's so much market to be served, right? That I think we have a little bit of a scarcity mindset around competition, right? So I just try to find where's my area of opportunity, not, oh no, there's somebody already doing what I'm doing. That's something I want you to inherit and something I'm encouraging you to steal from me. However, what you will find is as you did research, if you did do that homework that I assigned to you in that video, and you went through and you narrowed it down to 3 to 5, more than likely what you probably found was somebody that is probably likely a strategic alliance, right? So maybe what you're looking for is somebody that does something that they serve a completely different segment of the market than what you serve. I would love for you to follow up with them. You've already analyzed, you've already looked into what they do. Lead with value. Hey, I see you're doing this. I'd love to contribute. I love your mission. I love your cause. Actually, I really, you know, I'm trying to break into the industry myself. I've done some work in this field before, but now I want to do my own business. I love what you guys are doing. I really resonate with it. Boom, 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 boom. I've done the research on you. I know what you guys are about. I'm doing something a little bit different, and I feel like there's a way we can collaborate and work together. collaboration early on is one of the biggest, single biggest growth hacks, as it were, that you can encompass, that you can embody. So I highly recommend you take advantage of people that already have an audience, that already have traffic, that have already done the work, and moreover, can provide you not only opportunities, but in many cases, mentorship, right? So in many cases, what you'll find is they do something a little bit different, and there's an opportunity for you guys to collaborate, work together, become referral partners, whatever the case may be. If they are indeed the right person you're following, this happened with me. My company was growing leaps and bounds, and there were opportunities that just didn't make sense for us. So we referred it out to people that were younger and getting started in the business. And we said, hey, these guys are great. We want to service our customers. We want to give them an option or a referral partner. Great. We also had people, this was in the moving business. We also had people in storage, right? Self-storage. And we partnered with them, and they referred us, and we referred them. When we were starting out before we had a website, that was a great way to go about doing it. Okay, and then lastly, I have one more for you to explore, and that's both online and in-person networking, right? So online, what I want you to do is find a bunch of groups, Facebook groups, whatever social media platform that you prefer. Find groups. I know LinkedIn has some as well, again, contingent upon your profession or whatever your business, you know, whatever market you're in. Find groups that are relevant to that specific space. And the reason being is that the best thing you could do is start engaging and having conversations with people in there. I have many clients that have literally been in some kind of a service-based business that have literally just gotten into Facebook groups for their specific market. Web developer is a good example. And they'll say something about, hey, I need help with a website. Boom, somebody that is a web developer, doesn't have a website yet, just getting started out, jumps in and says, hey, I'd love to help you out, give you some feedback, give you some guidance, and I'm also a freelance developer. Boom, there you go, you're off and running to the races, right? So get involved, interact with people, answer questions, show off your expertise, show off, it only takes 5 minutes a day. So utilize this global marketplace that we have that is social media to do networking. Back in the day, we didn't have that opportunity. I have many people that are expert networkers that were back in the day, we didn't have the opportunity for the internet. They're like, oh my gosh, this is a gold mine. I wished I had had this when I was first starting out, because you can connect with anybody in the world just like that. So amazing opportunity for you to not only further immerse yourself in the market, but to have conversations with people that are looking for products and services, much of which you already have or you're trying to sell. So it's a great opportunity for you to start expanding. And if at the very least, they're gonna start following you online if you're answering questions, and then you're gonna build your online presence and online audience as well. And then the last one, as I mentioned, is in-person networking. So there's a lot of different groups. One of my favorites is BNI. So BNI, I think it stands for Business Networking International. Ivan Meisner is actually the founder. He's a friend, has been on my podcast. It is a global network. And one of the things that's really special about BNI is they only allow, every chapter only allows one person per industry in one of their chapters. Meaning, if you come in and you have a salon, you're opening a salon, and they have an opening for a salon, guess what? You're the only salon in there. Now, here's what's special about what they do and the way they do things is you are held accountable to send referrals every single week. They meet once a week. It is a commitment. It is a time and dollar commitment. You do have to spend money to be a part of the group. But I know people that have been in certain industries that are the right fit for BNI that literally derive 80%+ of their annual revenue just from being in their BNI chapter. So it is a phenomenal way. Again, you want champions. You want people that are out word of mouth. Word of mouth is your best friend right now. It is your number one marketing ploy in addition to collaboration. So find a group, doesn't have to be BNI, any kind of a networking type group that's specific to business. I know of a couple, a friend of mine's in one called Provisors. I think you have to have a little bit of experience, like 10 or 20 years of business experience to be in that one. But there's a lot of them out there. I just recommend starting with something like BNI. I was in one, again, for my moving company, and I was the only moving company in the group. And we got some of our largest moves. We got $10,000 moves from being in that group. That one move alone paid for like 4 years of being in the group. And plus, you want to be, specifically when you're first starting out, you want people in your community to know who you are. Cross-pollination, word of mouth, that's going to be your best friend in your first couple years in business. It's going to literally be the lifeblood for you in a lot of ways. And it doesn't put so much pressure on you to have your social media assets flying or your blog driving traffic or your YouTube channel crushing it. doing that, rolling up your sleeves, getting to know people, immersing yourself in the industry is going to create opportunities for you to get not only your first customer, but your first 100 to thousands of customers. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this series. Don't forget, we are doing a complete masterclass, putting all the pieces together. Make sure that 2021 is the year you get your business off the ground, that you have the business that you both want and deserve. And you can finally kiss that 9-to-5 goodbye if you're still in a full-time job. We're also going to teach you how to make sure that you hit your revenue goals going into the new year. If it's not 2021, you're watching this sometime in the future, I promise you this business advice, it is tried and true. It lasts forever. I don't sell shiny bells and whistles and fancy marketing strategies. What I sell is tried and proven strategies to grow a business that I teach every single day to both my clients and students alike. Go to learnwithcmh.com. That's learnwithcmh.com to check out that free, 100% free masterclass. We're going to go about an hour and a half of information just like this, except we're going to go deeper. We're going to give you everything you need to make sure that your business is rip roaring while everybody else is sitting on the sidelines chasing bells and whistles and shiny ninja strategies and what have you and all that nonsense fluff that people try to teach about growing a business, whether you're on or offline. So make sure you check out that. Do not miss that masterclass. I promise it'll be worth every bit of your money spent and time spent to join that. So go to learnwithcmh.com. Hope you guys enjoyed this series, and I will see you in the next one.